Welcome back, Flutter enthusiasts. Today we're taking a deep dive into the intricate structure of a Flutter project. Understanding every file and folder within your project is crucial for efficient development and collaboration, so grab a comfy seat and let's explore together. Open up your File Explorer and navigate to the location where you saved your Flutter project from the previous video. Look for the project named first_app, which we created earlier. Right-click on the first_app project folder, and if you've followed along with our previous instructions and checked the box during the installation of Visual Studio Code, you'll see an option to open with code. Click on this option, and watch as your Flutter project magically opens up in Visual Studio Code. Now that our Flutter project is open in Visual Studio Code, let's take a closer look at each file and folder within the project structure. .dart_tool. This folder contains tools and artifacts generated by Dart. It serves as a cache for Dart tool-specific configurations and data. The contents of this folder are typically generated automatically and are used internally by the Dart toolchain. .idea. The .idea folder is specific to JetBrains IDs like IntelliJ IDEA and contains project-specific settings and configurations. These settings include things like project-level code style settings, run configurations, and other ID-specific configurations. Android. The Android folder contains all the necessary files and configurations for building and running your Flutter app on the Android platform. Inside this folder, you'll find files related to the Android Gradle build system, as well as configurations for app permissions, resource files, and more. Build. The build folder contains the output of the build process, including compiled code, resources, and other artifacts. It's typically generated when you run the app or perform a build operation. This folder is automatically generated and should not be modified manually. Lib. Ah, the heart of your Flutter project. The lib folder is where you'll spend most of your time writing Dart code for your app. It contains all the source code files for your Flutter application, including Dart files defining widgets, screens, business logic, and more. Test. The test folder is where you'll find all your widget tests, unit tests, and integration tests for your Flutter app. Testing is a crucial aspect of app development, and this folder helps you organize and manage your tests effectively. You can write tests using Flutter's built-in testing framework. Web. If you're developing a web application using Flutter, this folder will contain all your web-specific assets, configurations, and code. Inside the web folder, you'll find HTML, CSS and JavaScript files, as well as other assets like images and fonts used in your web app. Windows. Similar to the Android folder, the Windows folder contains all the files and configurations necessary for building and running your Flutter app on the Windows platform. This includes project files for Visual Studio, as well as configurations for building Windows desktop applications. .gitignore. The .gitignore file tells Git which files and folders to ignore when committing changes to your repository. It helps keep your version control system clean and organized by excluding files that are generated during the build process or are not essential for your project. .metadata. The .metadata file contains metadata about your project, including information about project dependencies and configurations. It's used internally by the IDE and build tools to manage project settings and configurations. Analysis_options.yaml. The analysis_options.yaml file contains configuration settings for static analysis tools like Dart Analyzer and Flutter Analyzer. It helps enforce coding standards and identify potential issues in your code by specifying rules and configurations for code analysis. first_app.iml. The first_app.iml file is specific to IntelliJ IDEA and contains project-specific settings and configurations. The IDE uses it to store information about the project structure, dependencies, and other project-specific settings. pubspec.lock. The pubspec.lock file locks down the versions of dependencies used in your project. It ensures that everyone working on the project is using the same versions of dependencies, preventing compatibility issues and ensuring consistent behavior across different development environments. pubspec.yaml. The pubspec.yaml file is where you declare all your project dependencies, as well as other project-specific configurations like the app name, description, and version. It's a YAML file that follows a specific syntax and structure defined by the Dart and Flutter ecosystems. readme.md. Last but not least, the readme.md file is a markdown file that typically contains information about your project, including instructions on how to run the app, contribute to the project, or any other relevant details. It's often used to provide documentation and guidance to other developers who may be working on or using your project. In addition to the folders mentioned above, you may also encounter other folders in a Flutter project, depending on your specific use case. For example, if you're building apps for iOS, macOS, or Linux, you'll likely see additional folders like iOS, macOS, and Linux, respectively. These folders contain platform-specific configurations and files necessary for building and running your Flutter app on these platforms. Another important folder to mention is the Assets folder. The Assets folder is used to store static assets like images, fonts, and other resources used in your Flutter app. These assets can be accessed and used within your app's code to enhance the user experience and add visual elements. Now that we've explored the structure of our Flutter project, let's dive into the default code generated when we created the project. Inside the lib folder, you'll find a file named main.dart. This file contains the code for a basic counter app, which is generated automatically by Flutter. This counter app is pretty straightforward. It allows you to click a button, and with each click, it increments a counter. While the code may seem daunting if you're new to programming, fear not. In this video, we're not going to dive deep into coding. Instead, we'll focus on running the project and seeing how the app looks and behaves. To run the app, we need to choose the platform on which we want to run it, whether it's web, Windows, or Android. In Visual Studio Code, navigate to the bottom right corner, where it says No Device. Click on it, and you'll see a list of available platforms appear at the top. For example, you'll see options like Chrome and Edge for web, and Windows for desktop. Below, you'll find your Android emulators listed. Let's select an emulator to open it. Once selected, you'll see the emulator appear below in place of No Device. Now, to run our default app code, click on the three dots above and select Run, then choose Run without debugging. After a short wait, you'll see our app running smoothly in the emulator. You can test it out by clicking the Increment button. Each click should increment the counter. And there you have it, our first Flutter app up and running. It's amazing to see how quickly we can get our app running with just a few clicks. But don't worry if you're feeling overwhelmed. Understanding the code will come with time and practice. That's enough excitement for today. In the next video, we'll take a closer look at Dart, the programming language used in Flutter development. Understanding Dart is essential for furthering our journey in the Flutter environment. Until next time, keep exploring, keep learning, and keep coding. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.